In this video, we're computing a really bizarre integral. It's the integral of cosine x times cosh x dx, where cosh is the hyperbolic cosine function. So if you're not familiar with the hyperbolic cosine function, I'll post a link at the top real quick to where I first introduced these functions and how their derivatives work. Now, the problem with this integral is that I immediately see I'm going to have to use the integration by parts looping trick. And the issue there is that differentiating these functions never makes them simpler. And the idea of this looping trick is that we eventually find a copy of the original integral as we're manipulating this expression. And then we're able to grab that copy and actually make use of it to solve the problem. So real quick, just as a way of highlighting what the issue is here. The problem is that differentiating these functions just doesn't make them simpler, and in fact starts to create a looping sort of behavior. So if I think about the cosine function, the derivative of that is negative sine, but the derivative of that is negative cosine. So we basically got back where we started. If you apply two more derivatives, we'll actually get back to positive cosine x. Cosh has a similar behavior, but it's actually even simpler. The derivative of the cosh function is the sinx function, the hyperbolic sine. And the derivative of the sinx function is just the cosh function. So neither one of these things is getting simpler as we apply repeated derivatives, and that's how we know the looping trick is probably a good method to try on this integral. So what we're going to do is start with an integration by parts substitution, and we're going to pick our trig function here, the cosine function, as our u. So let u equal cosine x, and then I need the differential of that. So du is the derivative of this function, negative sine x, times dx. Then the rest of the integral is cosh x dx. So we're going to let dv be cosh x dx. And this means v is the antiderivative of the cosh function, which is just the sinx function. So now we apply the integration by parts formula, and our integral transforms to u times v, which is cosine x sinx x, and then minus the integral of v times du, and that's sinx x times negative sine x. We can pull the minus sign out of that integral while we're working and just change this into a positive. So we end up with plus the integral of sine x sinx x. And now, of course, we end up with this integral that is no simpler than the one we started with. And that's just because of the looping nature of these derivatives. So we apply integration by parts for a second time. And one of the key points here is that we want to target the same piece of the integral to let u equal that piece. So we let u be equal to the trig function the first time around, and we're going to do that the second time around as well. So let u equal sine x, and this means du is going to be cosine x dx. dv is the rest of the integral, which in this case is sinx x dx. And so I have to get the antiderivative of the sinx function, which again is the cosh function. So v is cosh x. Now, applying the integration by parts formula for the second time, don't forget about this spectator out in front. We had cosine x sinx x in front of our integral. And then the integral transforms to u times v, which is now sine x cosh x, minus the integral of v du. So minus the integral of cosh x times cosine x, and I'm going to write it in the opposite order, cosine x times cosh x. So this is the moment where we see the looping trick paying off. What I have here is a minus sign in front of the original integral that we started modifying by using integration by parts. So everything we see in this line is a modification of this original integral. So we've turned it into these two terms out in front minus a copy of the original integral. So all we have to do here is add this copy of the original integral to both sides, and we end up with twice the original integral on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, we're left with cosine x sinx x plus sine x cosh x. Now, we are computing an indefinite integral, so at some point we have to add a plus c into this, but I'm just going to wait until the last line. The final move here is to divide both sides by 2, and we've isolated an expression for the original integral. So it's a really sneaky trick. This looping trick almost feels like calculating an integral without ever having to calculate it. I end up with 1 half cosine x sinx x plus a 1 half sine x cosh x, and this is our final answer, so time to throw in a plus c, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.